Welcome students, here we are dealing with chapter 2 of class 11th, that is biological classification. Now, to study the biological classification, we need to get familiar with these two terms, systematics and taxonomy. First, we are talking about systematics, right? Systematics is this studies diversity of life, study and classification of organisms with the goal of reconstructing their evolutionary history, right? So it means systematics involve the various kind of organisms, their classification and also their evolutionary relationship among them, right? So that is systematics. Another word is taxonomy. What is taxonomy? Taxonomy is the study of classification science, right? It is the science of identifying, naming and classifying organisms into group. That means it is a branch of biology in which we identify, we name and we classify organisms into the groups. We classify the organisms into the groups so that we can study them in a convenient manner, right? So here is the picture of the very famous, we can say, botanist or physician Carolus Linnaeus, right? He proposed binomial nomenclature. He gave the binomial naming system. This is Carolus Linnaeus. Now, if we talk about the hierarchy of classification, if we take ourselves, if somebody is to reach to us, right, how can we get the particular person? For that we require, first of all, his geographical address, where does he live, right? Then the continent, in which continent the organism lives, your friend lives, right? In which country, if we know the country, then we need to know in which state. If we talk about India, then we need to know in which state he lives. In India, we say Rajasthan he lives. Then we come to the city. In Rajasthan, many cities are there. If we talk about any particular city, we can take the name of Jaipur. In the same way, if we go to Jaipur, we need to know the building, in which building he lives. Then if the building is very like multi-storied building, then we need to know in which floor he lives. Then in which apartment, right? So in the same way, we can locate, we can identify, we can classify the organism. So this is called the geographical address. And here the hierarchy gives a taxonomical address, right? If this gives a geographical address, then the taxonomical address is, first of all, we need to know the kingdom to which kingdom the organism belongs. We'll talk about the five kingdoms, right? If we know the kingdom, then we come to know to which phylum the organism belongs. Then class, order, family, genus, and finally the species. So it makes the taxonomical address of the organism,